libro primo della storia delle cose fatte dallo invitissimo Luca Francesco Sforza, scritta in latino da Giovanni Simonetta e tradotta in lingua fiorentina da Cristoforo Landino, fiorentino. Nei tempi che la regina Giovanna II, figliola di Carlo Re, regnava, perché era succeduta nel regno neapolitano a Ladislao Re, suo fratello, il quale...
Nazywam się Tessa Kaponi-Boracka, jestem Włoszką i mieszkam w Polsce od 24 lat.
Historia rodziny Caponi sięga, powiedzmy oficjalnie, to jest początek XIII wieku we Florencji. I rodzina należy do tego ścisłego grona oligarchów, które rządzą we Florencji. Pierwsze związki z Rzeczpospolitą są dość ciekawe, ponieważ odkryłam, że rodzina pośredniczyła w kupieniu przez kanclerza Jana Zamoyskiego obrazy włoskie. Na przykład wiemy, że Tintoretto, które on kupił, to było za pośrednictwo członkiem naszej rodziny w Wenecji.
La Sforziada, executed by Giovanni Simonetta, is one of the most marvelous Italian treasures held in the collections of European libraries. It is one of four copies, specially printed on parchment and decorated with the illuminations of Giovanni Pietro Birago, and features the biography of Francesco Sforza. The book found its way to Poland shortly after its creation. The remaining three copies are held in the British Library, Bibliothèque Nationale de France, and the Uffizi Gallery. Each of the four copies was made for a different member of the Ducal Sforza dynasty, and each was decorated differently. In the 16th century, the Italians of Krakow represented the largest immigrant community. They enjoyed the special legal protection of the monarch and remained outside the jurisdiction of the municipal authorities. Many of the patrician families in Krakow had Italian roots, and one in five citizens in Krakow spoke the language of Dante. Krakow attracted artists from such centers of Italian culture as Florence, Siena, and Rome. It was they who, between 1517 and 1533, oversaw the building of the Sigismund Chapel, considered the greatest work of Renaissance art north of the Alps. Italians also completed the construction of the castle on Wawel. The social position and affluence of those patricians in Krakow may be seen in the opulent tombstones of its most important churches. It was also an Italian, namely Bernardo Morando, who brought to fruition the dream of Jan Zamoyski and built the ideal city of Zamość. In the centuries to follow, the rich Poles still esteemed the works of Italian sculptors, painters and architects. The history of Polish artistic culture cannot be complete without the panoramas of Bellotto and the large number of paintings by Bacciarelli. His descendants live in Poland to this day, as do those of many other immigrants from Italy, for whom Poland has become their second homeland.